Hi, and welcome to this PanaTuVR Getting Started tutorial, where we'll build a simple virtual tour with 360-degree panoramic images. When you first open PanaTuVR, you'll see this welcome screen, where you can create or open projects. You can also get to this video tutorial and the documentation. I'll start a new project and select my equirectangular panoramic images. And now I'll create a virtual tour from them. And to do that, I'll add a web output. I'll add a skin, which I'll explain in a bit. And now I'll generate the project. And before PanaTuVR generates the project, you're prompted to first save it. And here's our tour. So PanaTuVR opens the project in your default browser, but it's not online yet. The project is only visible locally on your computer. So this is the skin, which features a controller to move to the other nodes of the tour. Now, a skin is an overlay that has interactive graphics that allow the user to interact and control the virtual tour. And these are a few of the skins that are shipped with PanaTuVR. You can also design your own skins with the skin editor, and we have a lot of tutorials to help you with that. This is a complete tour, and I could call it finished, but there are a few changes to the project I'd like to do first. So in PanaTuVR, I'll open the Properties panel, and in the Project User Data, I'll give the project a title. And now you'll see the project automatically updates with a new title. And this is happening because PanaTuVR has a feature called Live Update, where it'll update the output in the browser when you save the project. Okay, now I'll add more meaningful titles to each node. So in the User Data tab, I'll add a title. Now I'm changing nodes here using the keyboard shortcut Command right bracket. On Windows, this is Control right bracket. So now I'll save the project and refresh the browser. And now we can see our controller is looking a little less crowded and has more meaningful titles. Now let's change the viewing angles of these panoramas. I want to change the default view, which is the view or angle that's seen when you open a panorama. So for this task, I want more screen real estate for my panoramas. So I'll close the Properties panel. I'll spin this first node to where I want it to open up to, and this looks like a good view. So I'll right-click in the viewer and choose Set Default View. And I'll do this for all the nodes in the project. Again, I'm using the keyboard shortcut to move to each node. And speaking of shortcuts, you can also use Command U or Control U to set the default view. All right, that's looking better. But now I see that I want to change the color of the skin. And I can do this here in the Edit Skin Configuration. And I think I want a more earthy color that kind of matches the beach here. Okay, that works. I also want to add a map to the project, so here I'll add one. There's also a new icon depicting a map. But there's this big empty space here that's for the node description, and I don't have descriptions. So in this skin's configuration, I can hide the description. And now the map is larger, and I don't have this blank space anymore. So currently, we are navigating through the tour only with the controller. I also want to navigate with hotspots. So to do this, we need to link the panoramas together. And you can create a link simply by dragging a node into the viewer. But if your images have location data, you can link them automatically. Using the tour map, you'll see we have map markers showing all the nodes. And this is because the images already have location data, so Pano2VR knows where they are, but they aren't yet linked to each other. And so here we can choose to automatically link the nodes, and I'll pick automatic linking closest nodes. And now we see these lines indicating the nodes are linked. In the output, we have hotspots and they link to the next node. And now we have multiple ways to control the tour with hotspots, the thumbnail menu, and the map. I'm almost finished with this tour, but I have two things I want to add. The first being a PDF. I have this brochure on Green Island that I'd like to include, so I'll just drag it to the viewer. And Pano2VR automatically recognizes it and adds it as a PDF hotspot. I'll add a title because I know that this skin supports hotspot titles. I'll save the project and refresh the browser, and here's the PDF. I have a video about Green Island that I also want to add as a hotspot, so I'll drag in the URL, and like the PDF, Pano2VR recognizes that this is a YouTube video and also adds the video's title. So there's nothing else for me to do, so I'll save the project, and this time I'll export it. When you export the project, Pano2VR creates a folder with all the files you need to add this tour to your website. You would just add this folder and link to the HTML file. But you can also upload the project to our hosting service. So to do that, click Upload, and you'll first be prompted to sign into your account on genome.com. And then accept the terms and upload. Now you should see your project in the cloud browser with this green symbol, which signifies that the project is uploaded and connected to this account. And now you can share the project's link, embed the project, or even use a QR code. You can also export the project as a package format to use in your CMS website, like WordPress, Joomla, or Drupal. You can also use the package format for offline viewing with our package viewers. And that's how to build a simple virtual tour with Pano2VR. And thanks for watching.